Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. As you all might know, the compact tractor is a very nice tool for doing landscaping and agricultural work and all other stuff. And when a front loader is attached to it, the possibilities are becoming even larger and you can do even much more work with it. And you can even create your own implements, like I've shown over here, the rig digger and also some other examples on my channel. Now, working with the front loader, there's always the risk of overloading it, which results in bending of the front loader construction. And on the internet and on forums, there's quite some discussion about bending of the front loader. So in the first part of this video, we will go together look into the mechanical principles of front loader bending. And in the second part of the video, I will give you 6 tips how to prevent front loader bending. So let's dive together into the bending of the front loader construction. Now, when there's a lot of weight in this bucket, there will be gravity force in this direction, pointing downwards. And as a result of the pivot point over here, there will be a bending moment in that direction onto the construction. Now, an important aspect with respect to your front loader construction is the pivot point with respect to the actuator, the hydraulic cylinders. And what you see is that the pivot point is over here and the actuators are above. Now, why is that so important? The reason is that when you now have a bending moment in that direction, like for example a load of your bucket at the front side, then the cylinders will need to have a pulling force in order to prevent the bucket from dropping down. So in a normal way of operation, using the bucket for instance, but the same is valid for using a root ripper like the Rhino Ripper or using a rake digger, as well as with a grapple, is that the normal operating force is always in that direction. That means that there's tension on your bars of your hydraulic cylinders. Now, why is that important? This is important because as long as I have a pulling force of my cylinder, I will have tension inside my metal of the cylinder bar, and as long as I have that, I will never have bending. And I can illustrate that by this metal ruler. I can pull on it as hard as I would like, but it will never bend. I can only try to stretch it, but it will not bend. Now, when will this bend? When I don't have a pulling force, I don't have tension in my metal, but I have pressure. So when I do it like this, this is when you typically have bending of your metal or your construction. And that's the same is with the cylinders. As long as I have a load on this side, creating a bending moment in that direction, no way I will bend my cylinders. Doesn't matter how far they are extended, because there's always a pulling force on it. If I make this 3 times as long and I pull on it, it will not bend, it will only stretch. Now, when do I have a risk of bending? When I have a bending moment in that direction. Because due to the pivot point over here, in that case there will be pressure inside this metal and not tension. With pressure inside the metal, you can have bending. What is now a typical case when that can happen? Neil from Message gave a very nice example. In this case, when you now drive back and you hit a rock or some resistance at the bottom, then there will be a force in that direction. And then the bending moment onto the construction will be like this. And then you get not a tension on your cylinder, but you will get pressure on your cylinder. You get a pressure force. And that's of course a risk, especially when you have those fully extended cylinders like I've shown here. And that's also exactly what Neil from Messex is explaining in his video, that when you drive back like this, then you have to be careful not to bend your cylinder. And then it's of course better to not have fully extended cylinders, but to curl back your bucket, that those extension is becoming as small as possible. So is it a coincidence that the cylinder is above the pivot? No, of course not. The engineers from the front loader thought well about it. As long as you have the normal operating force, the weight from a bucket, the rig digger trying to dig something up, or working with the Rhino Ripper, as long as you have your main force downwards at the front side, you have a bending moment in that direction, and as a result you will have tension in your cylinder bars. And with tension you will never get bending, no matter how long they are extended. Now, apart from bending of your top cylinders that curl your front loader, there's also another aspect important, and that's the strength and the stiffness of the front loader metal construction. Now, what is stiffness? Stiffness is the amount of deflection a construction has when you put a certain force onto it, or a moment, bending moment, or a torque onto it. That's what we call stiffness. Typically, the dimension of newtons per millimeter deflection. Strength is something different. When you put a force onto a construction, there will always be deflection. Now, as long as the force is limited, there will be elastic deformation. That means that when you take the force away, or the torque away, that the construction will go back into its initial shape. But when you have a too high force, the load is too high, then there will, on top of the elastic deformation, also some plastic deformation. And that means that when you take the load away, that you have a deformation that is still there. That's what we call plastic deformation. In engineering, there are multiple ways of defining the strength. You can see when starts the plastic deformation, or also what's the maximum amount of stress that a construction can have. But let us not make it too complicated for now. Important, however, is that when you take an arbitrary beam, that the stiffness of this beam is proportional with the width times the height to the third power. So it's much more important to have height than to have width with respect to stiffness of a beam. And I can show it by this metal ruler again. This metal ruler is very thin and very high, and it's very easy to bend it in this direction. But when I take it like this, the high end up, it's extremely difficult to bend it. Now, for the strength, this ratio is a little different. When you look at the strength for an arbitrary beam, it's proportional with the width times the height squared, so to the second power. So now let's look at the construction of the front loader. What you see is that the height of the front loader construction in this direction is much higher than the width in this direction. There's more than a factor of four difference. So what does it tell us? It tells us that the stiffness in vertical direction is about 64 times higher than the stiffness in horizontal direction. And for the strength, this ratio is about 16. Now, this is important to realize, because this shows that this construction is having a high resistance of bending in vertical direction and much lower in horizontal direction. Now, what you also see is that this ratio of height versus width is changing in the construction. It's very low here at this point, very high at the point where the actuators are connected. The same over here. And that exactly shows that this is created for vertical bending, because here the bending moment is small and it increases by the distance, because the bending moment is force times distance in like a dimension newton meters. And when you look at this construction with the large height and the small width, it's not ideal for torsion. Again, when I look at the mechanical ruler, which is an extreme form of height versus width, you can see that I can quite easily rotate it, because the stiffness of a beam for torsion is about proportional to the width times the height. And the same is valid for the strength. Now, the optimal construction for torsion is a circular beam. Now, when you, for example, would take this ruler and you would make a circular beam out of it, and it would be completely connected, so there would be a closed section, then the stiffness of the same material would be enormously and would not be able to rotate it. And that's because the shear stress is then possible to run around the section. But as soon as I make a slit into this cross-sectional beam, then the shear stresses cannot go around. And as a result, it will become much weaker for torsion. And that's also what you can see, because if you then turn it, there will become a warp inside your construction. And that's also what you see here, a circular beam. So this connection from left to right is very, very stiff for torsion. And that's exactly what Kubota has created by putting this circular beam in between the left and the right part of the front loaded construction, it will prevent torsion between the left and the right part of your construction. So what does it mean? It means that when we have vertical forces which are about the same, that you will only have vertical bending of your front loader. And the amount of vertical bending is limited by the hydraulic forces, and that's exactly where your construction is designed for. So that will never be a problem. But when you have a large difference between the force on the left and on the right, you will not only have vertical bending of your construction, but you will also introduce a torque in your construction. And the torque results in a deformation like this, and as a result of the angle, there will also will introduce a horizontal bending in your construction. And that's also why I always try to make an implement that I make myself very rigid at the interface towards the front loader, because I really want to prevent the difference in load and the resulting of torque and resulting of different forces onto the different sides of the front loader to prevent too much deformation of one of them and as a result bending. So the front loader is a really nice addition to the functionality of the compact tractor. You can quickly attach multiple implements to them. As you can see on my channel, you can even make some of them yourself. And if you use them wisely, you will also prevent that you're going to bend your front loader. So I hope you enjoyed the part about the mechanical principles of the front loader construction. So let's now look at the 6 tips how to prevent front loader bending. Try to have a balanced load on your front loader construction and avoid an undistributed load between the left and the right side, since this will result in a torsion into your construction and the resistance for torsion of your front loader construction is limited, which can result in a plastic deformation of tilt of your front loader construction. Especially when you work with larger weights at the front loader, make sure you have enough backside weights, because it will prevent tilting of your tractor, but also it will make operating the tractor much more stable. And make sure your tire pressure is according to the specified level, because a low tire pressure will reduce the stiffness of your tire and as a result a reduction of the operational stability of your compact tractor. Limit the speed of your engine up to about 1400 RPMs, since this will be more than enough to do most of the loader work that is required. And only if you need more force, you can increase the engine speed to have a higher hydraulic pressure. But as soon as you finish that, put it back, because it will make the system less sensitive and thereby easier to operate. Be aware that whenever you're working on sideways on the slope, that whenever you're lifting up something with your front loader, you will have, apart from vertical bending, also a horizontal bending component onto your front loader construction. And it doesn't matter how well you have distributed your load. It also doesn't matter how high or low you have your front loader device. Of course, for tilting, it's important that the center of gravity is not over a certain point and you have tilting, but with your horizontal bending component, it doesn't matter. As soon as you lift it from the ground, your horizontal component will come into this construction. And as I've shown you, your horizontal bending strength is much less strong as your vertical bending strength. So be aware of that. Whenever you operate your front loader that results in an upward bending onto your construction, like for instance driving backwards to spread out chips or dirt, then be aware that there's going to be a pressure force onto your cylinder. And a pressure force can result in buckling of your cylinder bar, or in other words, bending. Now, how can you prevent that? Of course, by limitation of the force and by limitation of the buckling length. And also in other situations, when you have an upward bending moment, avoid high forces when you have extended cylinders. For instance, by lowering your RPM, or don't push too hard on your joystick, and limit the extension length of your cylinder bars. Now, I hope you enjoyed the video about front loader bending and how to prevent it. If you have any questions or remarks about front loader bending or something else, please put them in the comment sections below. I will be happy to reply to it. Perhaps we could even have a lively discussion on the front loader bending and all the aspects around it. Thanks for watching and see you next time.